Hausman. That's an oldie but a goodie.
Yes. Did you know that the man who wrote that song, The Hokey Pokey, they had a problem with him at the funeral? Because when they tried to put him in the coffin, they had to put his left foot in and have his right foot out.
All right, very good. Mark Goldstein, did you know that? Hey, Mark, you're on now. Now you got your 5-minute instruction, so you're going to be manning the phones over there. 610-374-8800, 888-401-0459. The All Request Hour continues, and we're also raising awareness for Blankets of Hope. It's the chili, the famous Chef Tim's chili.
Our fifth year doing this, and it's basically become an annual event. And when it's over, people are asking when it's happening again. So it's a great community event that helps our organization, which helps the community directly.
Jeremy Rapp just texted me. He says, Mike, people are calling the radio station. Please give out the locations where they can pick up their delicious Chef Tim's chili for Blankets of Hope next Friday and Saturday.
Yeah, so... You know, next Friday, we're at the Why I'm Missing Redner's location from 9 to 12.
Hi, everybody in Facebook world! Happy Friday!
Woo-hoo! Berks County Redner's. We're at Redding Distillery Guild, which is here on Penn Street. Classic Harley-Davidson, Ridgewood Winery, Benchwarmers Coffee and Donut, Mount Penn Sports Cars, the YMCA in Sinking Spring, and 10 Tompkins Vist Banks. Queen City Restaurant, right there on Lancaster Avenue. And Emmanuel UCC will be selling chili on Sunday to their congregation.
Carl, there's going to be a quiz. Did you get write all those locations down?
Yes, I did.
All right, and if someone did not write those down, Mark, is there a website?
Yes, our website is blanketsofhopepa.org. The information is on there with the hours, and also Facebook, Blankets of Hope hyphen Berks.
And who are the recipients of these wonderful blankets that you distribute?
The homeless shelters locally. We have cancer patients, hospice patients, the children's homes, the fire, law enforcement. Like I said, even like McLean Cancer Center, people don't realize we donate blankets to them. So it's they're all local. So the money from this project, this fundraiser, that will stay locally for blankets and beds.
And in addition to broadcasting live on WEEU, WBYN, 830WEEU.com, we are now doing a Facebook Live video on the World Wide Web, Carl.
Yes.
So, yes, it was a Friday morning, and we were talking about Chef Tim's favorite chili. Anyway, so yeah, what's that from? The Dragnet?
Yes, it is.
That's what I thought. No, this is great because you were driving in New York City. Was it on Broadway?
Broadway? Yeah, Lower Broadway.
Lower Broadway. Yeah, what happened?
Downtown Manhattan. You can pick up WEEU right there.
Mark, say hi to everybody in downtown Manhattan who are listening right now.
Hi, Manhattan. Downtown Manhattan, right? How you doing?
Yep.
Start spreading the news and tell everybody to listen to WEEU. All right, Dave's in Bethel, 610-374-8800, 888-401-0459. Dave, happy Friday. Thanks for waiting.
That's okay, gentlemen. Listen, this is addressed to Carl. I think he will identify with it. I had a grandfather that was gifted just like Carl. If he heard a song, he could play it.
I'll be done, yeah.
He was a professional musician, and they going to say bummed around, but he took jobs when he could get them. He played in speakeasies, theaters where they had
hello, Mickey. Films,
a couple of bordellos, a couple of bars.
Can you say that on the radio?
Yeah.
No, I'm just joking. Yeah, but you played by ear, Carl, too, right?
I mean, yeah. Hello. Well, that hurts.
Tell the story. You were in Sunday school. You were 5 years old?
Three.
You were 3 years old?
Yeah. In love with my Sunday school teacher. And I just marveled at how she could make such beautiful music out of those black and white pieces of wood. And it fascinated me. I just love music, and I just love the instrument itself. To each his own. I just love piano, and I just think it's the backbone of both hands and everything else. The sad thing is... I was just going to say this... God bless you, man. Thank you. That's great to hear about your grandpa. I think that's wonderful stories.
Well, here's the story. I was going to ask for the sting like that lady did.
Oh, be glad to.
Because this was in the 20s, and they tried the family. When I say they, the family tried to get him to record, make a recording while he still could. Well, back then, they on the streets in Reading, I think there were two of them. They used to, for a dollar, you could make a record. Now, this was 78 RPMs.
Right.
Of the old Bakelite things. But you could make recordings. So, just on a whim, one day, when he was much older, he went in and made two records. One was My Buddy, and the other was The Rosary.
Okay.
And they played it from my great-grandmother, who was in a coma, and they thought it would help her. And they looked over at her. She recognized his style of playing, because when she was healthy, he used to call her Daisy, because her name was Daisy, and there was a song called Daisy.
Sure.
And he would play Daisy for her. Well, when she heard him playing My Buddy, she started to cry in a coma, quote. And she never woke up, but she cried when she heard that.
That's a powerful story. Yeah. Wow, that's a beautiful story.
And, you know, what was so cute was I heard it before it finally broke. I mean, this was like 80 years later. But when he played it, in the old style. I think they called it trilling.
Yes, yes.
Go ahead, Carl. Give us a little bit of that.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
There we go. Now here, this piano here has a honky-tonk effect, and it really sounds neat for the trilling, like... Story. Thank you.
Great
so
story,
much.
Dave. Thanks for sharing. Thanks for waiting.
No sweat.
Have a great weekend. All right, you want to do this thing? And by the way, folks, Mark Goldstein, he is our guest producer, Blankets of Hope, next weekend, next Friday morning. We're going to be broadcasting live from Redners in Wyoming.
Celebrity producer.
Well, there you go. A celebrity producer, folks. So call in right now. Come on. Mark's got to get some calls. Mike Faust just showed him how to do it. Yeah, so now you got to pick up your phone. I'll run over there, and Carl, you just fill some time there in case he gets stuck. Give Mark a call.
No problem.
Would you give him a call, please? 610-3. Is this microphone on?
Yep.
Testing 1, 2, 3. I don't know. No one's calling. 610-374-8800, 888-401-0459. It's the Sting.
Mickey Madden's watching. Mickey's watching. Thank you.
thing. Was that Marvin Hamlisch?
Yeah, he's the one that got the Oscar for it.
Absolutely.
For the Scott Joplin writing.
That's great stuff. And, of course, that was it Scott Joplin who wrote it?
Yeah, 1903.
Great. All right, the calls are coming in, 610-374-8800, 888-401-0459. A shout-out to Vicky. Where's Vicky listening in today? She's on Facebook Live. Is she in New Jersey or California?
Vicky.
No, Vicky Madden.
Oh, Vicky Madden. Okay.
Yeah.
Hi, Vicky. Happy Friday. All right, we have some more requests coming in. It's the All Request Hour, Karl Hausman. Oh, you played at the Governor's Mansion.
Oh, hi.
Your 12th year.
Yes, it was. It was great. I have to tell you this real quick. When I go on and do it like an hour show. It's in the main ballroom, like usually 2 to 3 p.m. And I love it. The piano is a concert grand from 1880. It's a beautiful piece, and it's like new. And so I do my stuff. And later on, Carol and I were sitting out in the hall. And there was, in the side room, a high school choir singing. They were from Penn State area. They were at Penn State High School. They were singing one Christmas carol after another. And all of a sudden, I said to Carolyn, wait a minute, what is that? I heard of them singing the most beautiful song I've ever heard. And I said, I'll be right back. So I ran into the room, went up to the choir, and listened to them finish the carol. And when it was done, I asked the girl on the side, or the end of the line, I said, what was the name of that piece? You guys are wonderful. And she looked at it and said, here it is. It's called In the Bleak Midwinter. And I said, ooh. She said, yes, it sounds depressing, but the lyrics are really uplifting. I said, thank you very much. I couldn't wait to get home and look it up. And I found out it's been sung by people like Julie Andrews, Susan Boyle, many of the colleges in England. It's a British tune written. The poem was written in 1882 by an English woman. And in 1896, an Englishman put music to it. So it's an old piece, but can I play for you?
Yeah, what's it called again?
It's called In the Bleak Midwinter. What it gets to is in the middle of winter, there's light and there's hope.
Take us to a break with that song. That sounds really good. Karl Hausman.
From the 1800s.
I know. I've never heard of that. It's a beautiful song.
I didn't either.
I can see why I caught your attention.
Then I talk to people now, if I'm in churches, and I know that. I missed it.
Great. All right, we got some requests coming in.
Fonda Miller's on here. Hi, sister-in-law.
The Mummers always do.
Oh, it's Golden Slippers.
The Golden Slippers. You want to come back with that?
Yeah.
So then you can tell the story.
Did you
about
see
the
mayor of Philadelphia wants to do away with the Mummers Parade?
I heard that.
It's 120 years.
You maybe want to comment on it. Maybe not. I'll have my finger on the button. How's that?
There's one thing I learned as an entertainer. Do not make controversial comments because you'll alienate your audience.
Correct. Yep.
I could say Trump's right or Trump's wrong, and I'm going to make some people mad at me.
Correct.
And it's just bad for business.
Stay in the middle.
Right. Just don't even get involved with it.
Yeah,
I play music. I'm going to help you feel good.
Correct.
Al Genton.
What do you got to say for
Al
yourself?
Al Gent from Florida.
What's that?
Al Gent from Florida.
Oh.
So Al Gent is on from Florida. Should
yep.
we give a shout out to Al Gent?
Al Gent. Al Gent. Fonda Miller's on. Sister-in-law.
Hiya, Fonda. Hiya, Albert.
Chrissy Hausman's on.
Albert Gent.
And Kendallin.
Kendallin, hi.
And are they all over the place?
Little
yeah.
Baby. All over the states.
Well, Florida. And we got Temple University. We got Birdsboro. We got Reading. We got Wilmelsdorf.
Woohoo!
Wherever Ricky Madden is, probably working.
Yeah, yeah. Thanks for tuning in, guys.
Yeah.
Gals.
Yeah.
That song, Sing, Sing, Sing. You know who wrote it?
Who's that?
Louis Prima.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, that is.
That's awesome. All right, we're coming back after this. You want to do a little Golden Slippers?
Sure.
Okay.
Definitely.
Hi, John. I can't stop dancing, though. I have to dance.
I love that movie.
Do you ever go to Punxsutawney, Pennsylvania?
No,
yeah.
No, but I couldn't even find Shaka Maxim. Punxsutawney. What?
Kendallin says hi, Pop Pop.
Hiya, honey. You can't relive this day over. She's a beautiful little girl. But you can remember it
forever. Hear it live on 830 AM. All right, Carl. Here we go.
Okay.
You ready?
Listening to Mighty Mike in the Morning on Feedback on The Voice 830 AM WEEU and 1160 AM WBYN.
Love that guy. He was a wonderful man on, excuse me,
on radio with his Elvis show, Elvis and Friends, for over 30 years.
Now you can see him online.
It was a pleasure. I was honored to work with Ron Cade when he would produce and bring on his Elvis shows down in the Philadelphia area. And it was great.
He's a legend in the Philly radio.
Yep,
just
he is.
Just going to do a little bit of rock and roll oldies, and Elvis would come on. But first, it was Sammy J, and then Jeff Crick replaced Sammy J. And it was a wonderful time. The place was always packed.
Also, Al Jen, listening down in Florida.
Al Jen.
Yeah, Al Jen.
Al said, why the sweater? It's 72 degrees.
Why the sweater, Carl? 72 degrees down the floor. Just rub it in, Al Jen.
Yeah.
And we have listeners all over the world tuning in right now with our Facebook Live and also WEEU.830WEEU.com. And we are also up there in Carbon County. You ever got to Lee Hyten?
Yes.
And Jim Thorpe?
Oh, yeah.
And
love
Palmerton?
It.
Oh, my gosh, yeah.
What a beautiful area in the fall.
Our band, the Kit Kats, used to work in Hazleton. So we had a lot of time in the afternoon to go and explore the area. I was a big
Hi, Springer.
I'm very fascinated by the history of the Molly Maguires up there. And I used to travel all over from Girardville.
How about that one place where they have the hand in the wall?
Yeah, that's at the in the jail cell.
Yeah.
And it's amazing. And nobody could erase that handprint.
And that guy said, you're going to hang an innocent man today.
That's right.
And my hand will be here forever. And it still is.
It's exactly right. I'm glad these... I'll tell you, the Molly Maguire territory up there was wilder than the Wild West was.
Really?
The Wild West was very tame in comparison to the 1870s Pennsylvania coal mining area. Fascinating history.
We'll have to do a show on that sometime.
Love to.
Got a history on. You can sit in and play some of the music from that era and talk about it.
But they really,
you wrote a Western, didn't you?
No. I went out west.
No.
You wrote a score.
Oh, the music.
The music score. That's what I meant, like a Western.
Yes, I did. That's another one. I couldn't plagiarize that one.
You played, was that Golden Slippers?
Uh-huh.
See, I remember I was a kid in the 70s, and they had a lot of breakfast cereal commercials and Saturday morning cartoons. And they used that particular tune.
Yeah.
Hold those golden grams, hold those golden grams, toasted with and cinnamon. You remember that, Mark Goldstein?
It definitely sounds familiar. Absolutely.
Yeah, but it's Golden Slippers, right?
Yeah, that came out around the 1890s, written by the same man. He had two hits in his life. The song before that he wrote was called Home Sweet Home. And then he wrote Golden Slippers many years later.
It's such a catchy tune. You guys were down with the Mummers. Oh, I know that song.
It's a sentimental song from the old days.
So you went down to the Mummers Day Parade on New Year's Day. What was that like?
I used to go every year when I was a kid, and like I mentioned to you earlier, my parents used to put newspapers down on the sidewalks for my little brother and I to stand on so that the cold would not come up from the cement through your shoes. And it worked. I don't see anybody doing that today, but maybe they don't wear leather.
Well, they changed it, right? The route used to go north to south.
It always came up Broad Street, going north and around City Hall. But now it goes south. And there's still 10,000 people in that parade. And they still get approximately 1 million visitors. New York City once tried to hire the whole parade. They wanted them to move it to New York. And the organization said, no, we're a Philadelphia group and we're staying there. So 120 years. So, like I said, the last time I went was 1960. I took a date, went there, we froze to death, and enjoyed the parade. But then Carolyn always wanted to go, and so it was in her bucket list, and we all went. We met with our family and had a great time there. And Carolyn finally got to do the Mummer Strut out on South Broad Street there, right down from the Kimball Center. And she was dancing there with one of the leaders of the string bands. He had his big fancy outfit on. But then the cops came over and made her get back up on the sidewalk.
She didn't get arrested then.
No.
What do they call those, brigades?
Yeah, they're brigades. They have your comic division, your fancy division. I go for the string bands. They always play those archaic, old-time songs. They're the kind I grew up with. They were old when I was little.
Yeah.
But they still play them today.
They're fun to listen to.
Yeah, they're wonderful.
Mark Goldstein, do they have a chili brigade? Maybe next year, right?
Yes.
When is the chili going to be available for people just tuning in? Then we got to go back to the phones. We got a full bank.
Yeah, Friday, January 31st at White Missing Redners from 9 to 12. And then next next Saturday at 28 different locations. Check out our website at blanketsofhopepa.org or go on to Facebook, Blankets of Hope hyphen Berks. Oh. And if you want to pre-order, you can call me at 610-223-8085.
And who's going to be at the Why Missing Renders from 9 a.m. to noon next Friday?
We have Chef Tim, we have Classic Harley Davidson, West Long Queen Club, Tompkins Bank, Ridgewood Winery. Still trying to get me a few others.
By the way, Monday's show, we're going to be talking with Mike Jupina, Penn State Health St. Joe's. We're going to take a look inside their emergency medicine department, and we'll talk about proper use of the ER. So that's Monday during the 11 o'clock hour. We'll be talking with our friends from Penn State Health St. Joe's. Did you give a website?
Blanketsofhopepa.org.
All righty. And you're also on Facebook as well.
And yes, blanketsofhope-berks.
I know what I'm having for breakfast a week from today. Carl and Carolyn said we didn't eat breakfast. We didn't know we were going to have chili for breakfast. Let's go to Donald in Green Hills. Donald, happy Friday. Say hi to our guests.
Yes. I just recently read a report that said that piano players never get dementia.
Really? I never heard that.
Yeah.
As Mike knows, my wife used to play piano.
Sharon, yep.
Down at Disney one time, contemporary.
Oh, I'll be done. Oh.
Beautiful rosewood piano there. So she asked, you know, can I play it? And she sat down and played this thing, and everybody got a crowd.
That's really cool. Yeah. Did you videotape it?
Years ago.
How
about the old piano roll blues?
You got it.
My favorite.
Nice, thanks,
Donald. It's all one word, and Hausman is spelled H-A-U-S.
Yeah, the old way.
The old way. That's not the German way.
Yeah, it is the German
way.
It's
a higher low German.
Yeah. I was watching The Third Man the other night. I never saw the movie.
Isn't there a Third Man theme?
Yeah. It was number one in America then, yeah. On a zither. So anyway, it was Joseph Cotton, Orson Welles, etc. But this guy in the movie, Joseph Cotton, was reading a letter from a Frau Hausmann. And then, see, but it's a high A in German, the same as English. You pronounce their A's as A. Hausmann.
Ah.
And the S is strong in the word. It's not Haus, like a Z. The S is only a Z at the end of the word in German. So anyway, it gets a little complicated, but it is Hausmann. But everybody says, hey, Hausmann. It's all right. I've been called Hughesman, Hausman, and I can't tell you what my first wife used to call me.
Larry's in Bowmansville. Larry, happy Friday.
Happy Friday, Mike, and you got the best musician on I've ever heard.
God bless you. I'm voting for you in November.
Well, we go back. I came out of the service in 63, and 2 years later somebody said, you're going to hear this group from out of Philly, and I said, who are they? He said, Kit Kat.
Oh, my God.
Never heard of them. I was in California for 4 years in the Bay Area. So you hadn't made any records yet, I guess.
No.
Maybe just local.
Yeah, not for another 3 years. Yeah, I was just talking to Big John a week ago. He lives up around, he lives about up near Lake Wollumpaupack, above the Poconos. And Ronnie's still in Bucks County.
Okay.
They're doing good.
I'm glad to hear that.
Yay.
I remember the T-Bar and the Lake.
Oh, my God. Great. Yeah, the village.
Yeah. I'm 77 now,
Okay.
I still dance, and I saw you about 2 years ago in Exeter with an old friend of mine, and I wear the hack. And I dance. You play?
That's great.
And one time better than me. Did you write that?
Yes. I wrote it back
in...
I sang the harmony on it. Big John sang the lead. One Fine Better.
That, your voice, I think you could have sang more. Your voice wasn't, you know, maybe the greatest in the world, but you could do Need You, and I love that record.
I loved it too. I just read about him. I looked him up. A few years ago, he was sitting on a couch with a girlfriend, showing his new pistol. And he turned it around and accidentally shot himself and killed himself.
We're talking about Donnie Owens.
Donnie Owens, yeah. He and Duane Eddy used to work together with a group out in Phoenix, Arizona.
And he was on Dick Clark. Well, you were on that label too, Jamie.
Jamie Guyton, that's right.
You're on that label also.
Uh-huh.
I can never figure out that these guys didn't make a bigger hit. Let's Go
It was right. It was regional. It was big here. It was big in other spots. Oddly enough, in San Francisco, our first record, which was That's the Way, was number one in San Francisco. And we had another song that was number one only in 42 cities in Florida, and it was called You've Got to Know. So we wound up being regional hits and everything. Won't Find Better was the only one that went national. Great.
On occasion, I'll play them along with all the other good
sure.
rock and roll hits of the 50s and 60s, which are not played on
unfortunately,
no. Well, we're not really a heavy music station, but we do, Larry, I do play some of those oldie but goodies every now and then as a bumper.
I know you do, Mike. Yeah. You do. You will plug. You have to do what you're told, and I know that.
Well, it's just that we're not really doing the whole music, you know, it's more talk radio, but I get your point. You don't hear those as much, Larry, on the radio like you did years ago, and I agree with you. They're gems. I mean, they really raised the bar, Carl. I mean, I include the Beatles in that category. The talent was just unbelievable back then.
Yes, it was.
Well, 740 in Toronto, Canada at night, they play oldies continuous. 740 in Toronto, Canada.
Okay.
Right. Speaking of Toronto, you have an incredible story. Larry, thanks for the call. Did he give you his request? Larry, what did you want to hear again, Larry?
Won't Find Better.
Yeah. And then you have a story about the band.
Yes.
The rock group, The Band.
Mm-hmm.
And you had a gig in Toronto?
Yes. Okay.
And what were you doing there in Toronto? You were opening up for The Band? What were they called back then?
I'm 18 years old. It's 1960. I'm working with a group from the Midwest called Roscoe and the Green Men. And we were at the Edison Hotel in Toronto. Now, on our breaks, we would go next door and watch a really famous group. They were called Ronnie Hawkins and the Hawks. They were at Le Coq d'Or, something with a big rooster picture on it. Anyway, we go in, and Ronnie Hawkins had already had two big national hits, 40 Days and Mary Lou. We enjoyed that group very much. And I was asking his piano player, how do you get such a great sound out of your piano? My mic keeps feeding back. And he said, I'll get you the information. So a couple days later, at my hotel door, there's a knock. And the guitar player's at the door, and his name was Robbie Robertson. And he was new to me, and little did I know who he would become in the future. So he came in my room, sat down on the edge of the bed, and I sat in a chair, and he explained to me, if you want to have the perfect mic, get a ukulele pickup. And I smiled, and he said, yep, a ukulele pickup. You'll never get feedback. You just wedge it in against the backboard of the piano and keep it in place with a couple of bar napkins. And I thought, easy to do. So I went out and I bought a ukulele pickup. It was $11. And I still have it.
That's funny. That's a great story.
Yeah. And then I got to meet the fellas in the band. Levon Helm on drums. The piano player was Willie Lee Pops. And he was from Tennessee. Little did I know that one day Robbie Robertson, Levon, and they would become a group called The Band.
And they had a lot of hits.
They became world famous, right. They were Woodstock.
Up on Cripple Creek?
Yeah, up on Cripple Creek. And the number one I love was the night they drove the old Dixie down.
Did they do the Take a Load Off Band?
That's right.
Take a Load Off Band.
Yeah, you got them.
They had a lot of hits.
Yes, they did.
Yeah. All right, go ahead, give Larry's request. Here you go, Larry. Your request now continues. We're going to get into this. You're going to call it.
One request.
Yeah.
Ron Cade asked if I could play Last Date.
Absolutely.
It's a short song.
You want to come back with that?
Yeah, it was a number one song.
Why don't you come back with it and I'd send
okay,
it out to Ron. And then
great.
We'll let Mark give a plug. And then we'll have you play us out. Anything else you want to promote? The peanut bar, the book. And then maybe I was like the Disney medley.
Yay!
You want to end with that?
Sure.
All right.
All right, bye.
Woohoo! Beautiful.
Oh, I appreciate you coming in. Thank you, sir. Thank you, guys.
Ed Perkins is on, Carl. Ed Perkins. Ed Perkins is on.
Ed Perkins.
Yeah.
Oh, hi, Ed. Oh, you're great.
It's another
guy.
Philadelphia DJ.
Oh, let's say hi to Ed. We
Ed
come
Perkins.
Back. Hi,
yep.
Ed. Happy Friday.
We got Lois Sutton in Campbelltown.
Lois.
Amanda's down in the Philly area. Who else do we have?
Well,
Jessica Diedrich.
We come back. We'll do a shout out. There.
Sharon Graham and Pat Tyson. Everybody's listening. John Prang. He's a great veterinarian, retired now, and Ron Sabiniak. Thank you, everybody. Keep watching. Eat chili.
That's coming up you want to promote for this winter and even early spring besides the peanut bar.
We're at the Highlands on Valentine's Day.
You want to promote the Highlands?
We're gonna be
the public?
No, she's not.
I love it.
Mike.
Highlands on Valentine's Day. Yeah. February 14th.
Yeah.
Yes.
I'm going to say, I think we'll start with them. I wanted to ask, and it was a bad time to sing. It's a wonderful thing with the blankets and all. But I was going to say, if we're here to help the helpless, what are the helpless here for?
Oh, Jesus God.
That's an interesting thought.
It's a rhetorical question.
Yeah, yeah.
And I have a cure for the hungry.
What's that?
have the hungry eat the homeless.
Oh, he's sick. Golly. He's sick. Idea. He's really sick.
He's here all week.
I'm telling you.
Try the veal.
Don't marry a piano player.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. The sick jokes I read.
So I can also say that if anybody's interested in Carl coming out to their programs, senior citizens, nursing homes, retirement facilities, music.
Call the number?
Music is the answer, 610-207-9990.
I had a lifetime of those.
Yeah.
Although he does happy hours at the Keystone Villa in Fleetwood.
Yeah. Is that fun doing happy hour?
Yeah, they do happy hour.
I think that's water.
But that's fun.
I like what Seinfeld said. He said, I hate drugs. He said, they're either telling you how much they hate you or how much they love you.
We do a monthly gig. He does a monthly, the first Saturday of every month, either Country Meadows 1 or Country Meadows 2.
Yeah, go ahead, plug away.
He's in Elmcroft in Exeter, the first Saturday of every month from 6 to 7 p.m.
Yeah, bring your bags.
Yeah, bring your bags. Check the places out. They love when you come into the retirement places because you get to see them.
Yes.
And the people are happy.
Yeah, especially this time of year. Huh? Take the first step in breaking
through the stigma of addiction. All right, got one more coming back after this. So you're going to come out of the break with Big Ron song.
Yes,
And then we're going to do a little talk back and forth. One more plug for that.
Uh-huh.
And then you want to plug, and then we'll finish with the Disney theme.
Okay. Or we could do... For the chili.
I always like the part. You
can't beat that song.
It flows.
Yeah, that's Walt Disney to a T.
Yeah,
it
absolutely.
Just sums them up in one song.
Here we go, my friend.
Okay, here we go, my guy.
Here we go, Carl.
Miguel. Mike Faust on The Voice, 830 AM WEEU and 1160 AM WBYN. Song that he had Elvis and Friends. 42
Congratulations,
years.
Big Ron. Yeah. Absolutely. And also, Ed is listening.
Ed Philadelphia. Ed Perkins, wonderful guy.
Yes, too. Another Philadelphia radio DJ legend.
Super.
And we got a lot of people in Philadelphia listening. So we thank all of our brothers and sisters listening in Philly right now. The city of brotherly love.
Yeah.
Lots of love coming from there.
Ed's on WRDV.
So far this year.
Oh, my golly. Hey, we were running out of time.
Yeah, but they're mostly
running out of time.
Family members or best of friends. So it is the city of love.
My goodness. Mark, we're running out of time. Where are we going to be at?
We're going to be at the Why Missing Redners on on State Hill Road there from 9 to 12 is Chef Tim's Table, serving up some chili.
What's the phone number to call for your order?
If you need to order half trays or full trays, it's 610-223-8085.
Thanks for hanging out with us for 2 hours. Wasn't this fun?
This was awesome. And just imagine, did you think we'd be doing this 30 years ago?
No, I never had a clue. Unbelievable, Mark. You're the best. Appreciate we'll be hanging out with you for 3 hours next week.
Absolutely.
At the Red Rooster Wine Missing. And then the phone number to book you, Carl. How does it work?
You go tell him, boss.
610-207-9990.
And you're booking fast for 2020.
Absolutely.
Right, Carl, always a pleasure, my good friend. Thank you. How about some Disney to take us out of here? Have a fantastic weekend.
Everybody. Thank you.
Thanks, everybody. Thank you. Come again.